Let's take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting New York Yankees as Joe Girardi's starting nine assembles this way. They'll match up here against a guy who's really come into his own, the right-hander Jordan Zimmermann. Standing in, the leadoff man, Jacoby Ellsbury. So we are ready for baseball.
Number 22.
And underway this afternoon as the first pitch is hit on the ground to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there's your first out of the ball game.
Well, that's a nice job right there to readjust to that curveball. I don't know if he was sitting on it or what, but he certainly hit it hard. Unfortunately for him, right at someone.
Brett Gardner is ready for his first AB here in this one. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1. We'll be in the 80s later this afternoon, but for now, 79 degrees at first pitch. Swing and he pops him up right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate, and he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Well, that'll be a frustrating at bat for him. Now, he's got to be thinking he let one get away there, because you know that's a pitch he should have been able to handle.
Into the box, Alex Rodriguez, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one.
Yeah, you know, first time through, he likes to start guys off with a fastball. And it's a good one, too. You know, he'll run it up there in the mid-90s.
Now here's a bouncing ball headed for Iglesias at short. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. Yankees nothing. Tigers coming to bat. You're watching Major. Here's a look at the starting lineup for the Tigers now. Luis Severino will have the challenge of stopping these guys. This is a guy that's got a workhorse mentality out there, not afraid to throw a lot of pitches, but if he gets careless with his location, he can be hittable. And a look now at the defensive alignment for the Yankees behind him. Ian Kinsler comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Second baseman, Ian Kinsler.
And he'll start him with a fastball that misses down and away for a ball, 1-0. Now a ball hit back up the middle. To his left, he's there. Throw, and he's called out on a close play at first.
Batting second.
And with one away, we'll give you a look at the dimensions here at Comerica Park. First opened in 2000. Pretty rough on right-handed hitters. 345 down the line in left, one of the deeper porches in baseball. 382 to left center, a tough 420 straight away. And then a little more forgiving for the left-handed batters. 365 to right center, 330 down the line in right. Justin Upton is the batter now as he looks at a ball 1-0. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. Throw on to Teixeira, two down.
Well, you always want to avoid using a lot of energy in the early part of the game. And he's taking that to heart. Five pitches and two outs already here in the bottom of the first.
Miguel Cabrera is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. The pitch. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. You still come after him now on 2-0?
I think you have to be a little careful, but yeah, I don't think you can just give up on him.
Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd. Got a piece, it's 2-2. Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Three up, three down for Detroit. After one, no score. The first baseman, Mark Teixeira, makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
Mark Teixeira.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And this ball's pulled on the ground down the line to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself. And the leadoff man set down to start the second. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And here's the ever-dangerous Carlos Beltran. Not much behind this as this ball is looped over toward first. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in.
Batting six.
Brian McCann takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. He's set, now the pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw gets him, two down.
Yeah, and the only silver lining to this offensively is that you get that guy up to second base and now he's in scoring position with two outs. But I would doubt seriously that that was his intention.
From the stretch. Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. Oh, and he botches it. And the run will cross to make this a 1-0 Yankee lead. Starlin Castro, the hitter now with a chance to pick up that runner from second with two away. He waits, now the pitch. Now here's a slow grounder to the left side. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And they'll wind up with no play here as he reaches first safely. Didi Gregorius gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one.
Boy, I'll tell you what, after seeing two errors in the inning, as a pitcher, you pretty much have to go into strikeout mode.
Now here's a bouncing ball headed for Iglesias at short. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Yankees forced to settle for one. On now to the bottom of the second. It's the Yankees one, and the Tigers nothing. Victor Martinez strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning.
Victor Martinez.
Now here's a slider that can't quite get back to the outside corner. It's ball one. Here's a 1-0 cutter that's low, 2-0.
And this is all about handling a guy like this with kid gloves. You know, walk him if you have to, but Don't let him be the one to beat you.
And Gardner there to put it away for the first down. J.D. Martinez will stand in. He took home a Silver Slugger Award for American League outfielders a year ago. And a fastball is in there for strike one. That swung on and lifted down the left field line. There to take it is Gardner, and there are two away now.
Adding six, third baseman.
Nick Castellanos gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Pitch on the way. And who? Looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's nothing and one.
Whether you like it or not, now that you've seen what the strike zone's going to be like, you're going to have to make an adjustment.
Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
And this pitch is hit hard as it'll fall into right field for their first hit of the ball game. James McCann set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. Ball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
Now you've got the tying run over at first, two away. He's going to be looking to try and find a gap right here and bring that guy all the way around to school.
Swing and a miss for strike one. From the belt, kicks and deals. Swing and a bouncing ball to third. And a close play at first, but he's called out and the side is retired. Tigers leave one. They're down 1-0. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Jacoby Ellsbury.
Center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury.
Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. This is sharply hit back up the middle, and the leadoff man is going to reach here. He's got a base hit.
The left fielder, number 11.
Brett Gardner is into the box for his second at-bat. He popped out into foul territory his first time up. And a pitch out, nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. Runner at first is Ellsbury with nobody out.
Come on, Gardner, let's go.
Goes the other way, and this is in the air out to left. And this is taken in by Upton for the first out.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit. And it's an easy play out there in left field.
Alex Rodriguez stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. He's ready. Now the pitch. Oh, and A-Rod a little too anxious here as this is pulled foul into the seats down the left field line. Now a throw over. And he'll get back in safely. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Runners on first with one down. Runners going. And the 1-1 is in the air now out to center. Ghost is there now, and he has it. Two gone. Mark Teixeira stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. First pitch on its way to Teixeira. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. Two out with the man at first. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. Yanks leave one, but they're up 1-0. Jose Iglesias digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
The shortstop, number one, Jose Iglesias.
Let's get something started here.
And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. And here's a ball hit in the air. Teixeira is over, and he puts it away for the first out.
Center fielder,
Anthony Ghosh stands in. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Here's a swing and a ground ball. And Teixeira steps on first himself to record the out.
The batter, number three.
Ian Kinsler will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. Now here it comes. Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Here it comes. And he'll take the fastball here inside off the plate. It's 1-2. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Down in order go the Tigers. They still trail 1-0. Carlos Beltran is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
Right fielder, Carlos Beltran.
Here's the pitch. First pitch of the inning is bounced up the middle, and they're going to get themselves a base runner rather quickly here as that's into center field for a leadoff single.
Maybe these guys are going to start getting a little more aggressive here early in the count. This is the first pitch of the inning, and he's on base here to kick things off.
Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Now the 0-1 is swung on and lifted out to straightaway center field. Ghosh is there, and he has it for the first out.
Now batting, third base.
So a runner at first with one out now, and that'll bring in the dangerous switch hitter Chase Headley. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. And that'll get over the wall. So forget about sending the runner. It'll be second and third now with only one away.
I wonder if that ball doesn't hop over the wall, do they try and send him from third base? Well, we'll never know because there'll be runners at second and third now following that ground rule double.
Into the box now, Starlin Castro. And this is lifted out towards straightaway center field. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And it's a sac fly and an RBI. It's now a 2-0 game.
Well, nobody's going to confuse this guy with Miguel Cabrera or Chris Davis, but with the runner on third, he doesn't have to hit the ball out of the ballpark. Just has to get one deep enough out there to deliver that run from third. That's nice going.
Didi Gregorius will stand in for the second time as he watches one miss low. It's a ball and no strikes. He's set. Now the pitch.
Nope.
Just missing here. 2-0.
Boy, what a nice job so far of working himself into a hitter's count. Now he can go to work on maybe picking up that two-out RBI out of the nine hole.
And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. And that is a fair ball as this one's heading for the left field corner. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Jacoby Ellsbury steps in to try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. Now the pitch home to Ellsbury. And good contact there as this is hit high and deep to right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Around third and being waved on home. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Just can't seem to get out of the inning. Another run is in to score on the two-out triple. And now there's even more pressure on the defense to keep this to just a three-run inning.
Now the Tigers have some action in the bullpen as a left-hander starts to get loose. In now, Brett Gardner, as he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. Throw on to first, and they're able to escape the monster inning as the side is retired. So three runs on four hits, no errors, and a man left on. To the bottom of inning number four we go. The Yankees 4, and the Tigers nothing. Justin Upton will start things off in the inning for Detroit. He'll be followed by Miguel Cabrera waiting on deck. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. And he misses with it, 1-1. Now a ball lined to the right side. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning. Miguel Cabrera will stand in here, the reigning batting champion in the American League. He's ready now. The pitch. Cut fastball in there for a called strike.
Now here's a good spot to finally break through against this guy. You've got the leadoff man on, the heart of the order's coming up, and maybe this is a good chance to get that goose egg off the scoreboard.
And reined in, one away.
Just coasting right along here. Gets another pop-up, and look, he's barely breaking a sweat out there.
Victor Martinez is at the plate now, flied out in his first at-bat. Slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort. Foul back. No runs, two hits, and two errors for the Tigers to this point. And this is fouled straight back. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Yeah, an interesting setup now on 2-2. Here's where you really need to pay attention to that guy at first.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. J.D. Martinez is into the box for his second appearance, 0-1 with a flyout. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two.
Now 0-2, you got to be wary of that changeup. This is where he likes to throw it, and it doesn't always have to be a strike.
And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Beltran is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. One left for Detroit. They're down 4-0. Alex Rodriguez heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Designated hitter, Alex Rodriguez.
A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. And the pitch. And that swung on and fouled straight back. And A-Rod is on base. It's a base hit.
You talk about getting the bat head out in front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
Kyle Ryan is going to take over here in inning number five, as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep them in the game here. Stepping in now, Mark Teixeira. In the air to center field, and deep back is the center fielder. Back he goes, but this is going to be a home run. It's a two-run home run for Mark Teixeira. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
How's this for a welcome to the ball game? One pitch and see you later. I've got a feeling that's not what the manager had in mind.
Standing in now, Carlos Beltran. First pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air to straightaway center. Goes will wait on it, and he's got it for out number one. Brian McCann will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Some action now in the Tigers' bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. Hit hard to the right, but foul. Now here's the pitch. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. But this will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And standing in is the third baseman, Chase Headley. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away. And that ends the inning. The Yankees get a couple on the two-run home run. On to the bottom of the fifth. And it's all New York, 6-0 Yanks. Nick Castellanos will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. One and two as he chases the slider. Here's the ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first out. James McCann stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike, nothing in one.
Just no chance to pull the trigger on that pitch. That's on him way too fast.
And he looks like he's toying with him here. It's 0-2.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
You know, and I think most hitters will tell you, if you get a bad call on strike one or strike two, you know, they can live with that. But if you're going to punch me out on strike three, it better be a strike. If not, I feel like you're taking the bat out of my hands.
Jose Iglesias is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
Ball one. The slider up into the 90s there. It's 1-2. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Three up, three down for Detroit. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Starlin Castro will start things out for the Yankees here in their half of the sixth.
Second baseman, Starlin Castro.
Now the pitch. First pitch of the inning here is wrapped right back from where it came, and that'll get into center field for a leadoff single.
Man, these guys have been aggressive here early in the count. Some people think, oh, you might want to take a pitch to start in that bat, and sometimes that's great, and it works out for a lot of people. But what you should be thinking is, I got to swing at strikes, and I got to get my pitch. And if it happens to come on the first pitch, let it rip.
Into the box now, Didi Gregorius. Hard hit towards center. Ghost is right there, one down.
Now batting.
Jacoby Ellsbury, tripled homer run last time through, so let's see what he's got in store this time. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. And he'll try to bunt that man to second, but this one kicks foul. Six runs, nine hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. And this is on the ground to first, could be two.
Well, if you're looking for a reason why this club is losing, three errors so far in the game. And the fundamentals, they're just nowhere to be found right now.
And he squares and bunts this one hard. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
Yeah, a nice job there to give himself up. See, they put the tag on him as he's running to first. That moves two guys into scoring position now. Only one out.
In now, Alex Rodriguez. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. And the second run will score as well. Mark Teixeira will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. First pitch on its way to Teixeira. And this is swung on and bounced on the ground to third. And he'll go the short way to retire the side. So two runs on two hits, one error, and a runner left. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. The Yankees lead it 8-0. Anthony Gose will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had him off balance all game.
Way late on the fastball for strike one. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. This one for the shortstop, Gregorius. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
The batter, number three, second baseman.
Ian Kinsler will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Pitch on the way. And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one.
He's getting a lot of outs right now because he's attacking the hitters. He's not dancing around the zone.
I had him reaching at thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2. Now the pitch. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, this is one of those situations where his guys got him the lead early on, and he's been in complete control ever since. I mean, he's barely been threatened out there.
Justin Upton will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Yeah, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Now a swing, Owen. Look out over in the third base dugout as that thing nearly took out half the coaching staff.
Here you go in show motion. He puts a lot into this swing, and then on the follow through, you see it just go whoop. That's why you always got to stay alert.
Looking at a fastball to end the inning. Down in order go the Tigers. They're on the short end of an 8-0 score. Blaine Hardy will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Carlos Beltran will start things off here for the Pinstripers. He'll be followed by Brian McCann waiting in the on-deck circle. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. Brian McCann will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. And this will be fouled away. One out, nobody on. Goodness, 0-2 now. And he'll fight to stay alive here as this is reached for and fouled away. Here comes another 0-2. Now a swing and a miss on a pitch well out of the strike zone as he becomes the second out. Chase Headley digs in now after lining out in his last try. Swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit.
The batter number 14.
Starlin Castro steps in. He scored after reaching on a single this last time up. Come set. Now the pitch. And this is cut on and missed below the knees, and it's 0-1. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. So a two-run homer down the line in left as the blowout continues.
Well, you know what has a tendency to get overlooked here? that two-out single that kept this inning alive. I mean, you take nothing away from the guy that just hit the home run, but this is what happens when teams put up a fight there with two away. Pays off for him big time.
Stepping in now, Didi Gregorius. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Two out, nobody on. In the air to straightaway center field. Ghost will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the Yankees 10, and the Tigers nothing. Miguel Cabrera will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far.
Miguel Cabrera.
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Who pulled the string and had him way out in front, a ball and a strike.
And he's just running right through these guys. Absolutely worn him down.
Now one hit fouled over to the right side as the count moves to 1-2. And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
Boy, you talk about a guy getting himself in a groove. How about 10 in a row, he's retired now. Just making it look easy.
Victor Martinez will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
And even though he's pitching well, this is a part of the order that he's really got to worry about. Now they can turn a good outing into a bad one pretty darn quickly.
And Headley will look this one in for out number two.
Another guy retired there. You see his pitching line to this point. It's phenomenal. Just two hits. Both of them are singles. And he's hardly even been in trouble. Thorough domination so far.
J.D. Martinez is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Who jumped the gun a bit on that swing, and he's down 1-2. Got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. 3 up, 3 down for Detroit. Starting to look bleak, down 10-0. Jacoby Ellsbury comes to the plate, and he'll start us off in the 8th.
Center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury.
There's Kinsler at second. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. 8th inning from Comerica Park with the visiting Yankees on top of the Tigers as you get a look at the line score to this point in the game. Here it comes. And now the second pitch of the inning is hit in the air to center. Goes. Comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number 2.
Up next for the Yankees,
Alex Rodriguez will dig in. He singled and drove home 2 his last time. Now here's the pitch. Hammered the other way to deep right field. A leap, but he won't get it. It's off the wall. And he is in to second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon.
Man, I'll tell you, it seems like all game long, he's been on every pitch that he's seen. This one's no exception. And it might be his best swing so far. This just about gets out of here, and he'll wind up at second with a double off the wall.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. Nick Castellanos will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in 2 trips thus far.
Nick Castellano.
Now here it comes. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. And one and one as this one's in on the hands. And a fastball swung on and hit to second. And the throw by Castro takes care of him for the first out. James McCann will have another go. He struck out looking his last time. The pitch. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Now here's a swing and another chance out there at second. Throw on to Teixeira, two down. Jose Iglesias will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. Center field. Ellsbury is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Down in order go the Tigers. Lead looks insurmountable here. They're down 10-0. Justin Wilson will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Carlos Beltran strides in, grounded out his last time through.
Right fielder.
Now a swing on the first pitch as he sends this one out to the second baseman Kinsler. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Brian McCann ready to try again. Struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now here's the pitch. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
Not a real good effort there. Now, it's one thing if it's a slider running away or something like that, but that pitch right there was never going to be a strike.
Another 0-2 coming. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. But foul. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. And this is swung on, and it'll be another chance out there at second. Up with it is Kinsler. On to first, and McCann is retired here for route number two.
Chase Headley.
Chase Headley digs in. He reached on a single and would later wind up scoring in his last at bat. And now a pitch on the way. Fouled straight back. Oh, and Headley can't come up with that one as he swings through it for strike two now.
This is the trouble when you're facing a guy like this. You get into a hole, and now you don't know what to look for. He's got
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. Anthony Goes will stand in now to begin their half of the ninth in a game that was decided long, long ago.
Yeah, this is mop-up time out there right now, but hey, these at-bats still count against your batting average, so you can't go up there and just mail it in. You've got to see this through right to the end of the game.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Look into McCann, the 1-1. There's a swing and the ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. Now a ball sprayed fouled into the seats near third. Not the greatest swing that time as this is hit back toward the mound. On to first, but it's too late as the first base umpire says they just missed getting him at the bag. Ian Kinsler will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-for-3 thus far. From the belt, the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
That's a good location for that cutter with two strikes. He's either got to take that and hope it's a ball, or he's got to foul that thing off.
Another 1-2 delivery to two balls and two strikes now.
And this guy's a grinder up there. You know he'll give you a tough at-bat.
But this is hauled in by the second baseman.
Now, story of the ball game right there, and that's how it goes sometimes in baseball. The hard hit balls find gloves, and the little dribblers find holes.
Justin Upton comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Has a look, now the pitch. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far. Miguel Cabrera will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Come set. Now the pitch. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And with that, I can finally say the four words I've had on my mind for what seems like an eternity. This ball game is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout this game. He was completely in charge, essentially, from pitch one. And now he finishes off a masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. And guys, you can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, he definitely turned in the standout performance in this one. He finishes with an even 10 strikeouts, and he was instrumental in leading his guys to the victory.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, get those smartphones and tablets out and head over to theshownation.com. The Yankees come out on top, 10-0. So long from Motown.
Our final line score this afternoon, first for the Detroit Yankees. 10 runs. 13 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Tigers, no runs, 3 hits, 3 errors, also left three men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 13 minutes. Our paid attendance at Comerica Park this afternoon, a sellout of 40,000. The Tigers thank you for attending today's game and remind you to buckle up and drive home safely.